Now, Cosatu is concerned about its proposed COVID-19 vaccine certificates. It says they should not be open to abuse and fraud. It says this will damage the credibility of the certificates, and government intends issuing the documents which will be used for access to events and travel. For more on this, we are now joined by Sizwe Pamla from Cosatu. Good morning, Sizwe. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, why are you so skeptical about the vaccination certificates?
Well, firstly, we, as workers, we know that we are in an abusive relationship with most employers, and most employers not necessarily abide by the law, the regulations at a shop floor level. So we are firstly cautious of giving employers the power to really take these kinds of decisions that can result in workers being dismissed, that can deprive people of the right to earn livelihood. Already with the laws that are currently in place, we're struggling to ensure that employers act in a fair manner. So if you then hand over this kind of power to people with a history of abusing their power, then for us, it is a big concern. But secondly, the whole idea of vaccination really is about people getting vaccinated. And in South Africa, we do have a problem of corruption. Now, if you start to talk about certificates, you are actually shifting the conversation from vaccination to certificates. Now, instead of people being persuaded to go and vaccinate, they start to think of ways to have access to these certificates so that they can continue with their lives without necessarily getting vaccinated. You do have people with driver's licenses on the road, and they are legally allowed to be on the road. But if you were to test them, you would realize that they actually don't know how to drive. So these are the problems that are already there in South Africa, where we have corruption. And if you start to say to people, look, you will be deprived of access to some areas if you don't have a vaccine certificate, and then people will just bribe their way into those areas instead of then going to vaccinate. So it will end up defeating the whole purpose of the vaccination, which is vaccinated, and everybody will focus on access, where the access is denied to them, either to bribery or just paying their way into getting those certificates. This is a problem that we've seen in many other areas of South Africa.
All right. So, Sizwe, you are saying basically that you are concerned about corruption when it comes to the vaccination certificate rollout program, or, you know, the digitalizing of the vaccination certificate. But then you also mentioned that, you know, you're also concerned that employers might, you know, dismiss their employees if they don't have a vaccination certificate. But then you also want people to go and vaccinate. You know, isn't it, you know, better for people to rather go and vaccinate, get the vaccination certificate, so that they can show this to their employers, everybody's safe in the company, and we go on?
No, indeed, we do encourage people to vaccinate, which is why we are partnering with government, we are partnering with other social partners. In fact, we have made it very clear to employers that we want to work with them and to persuade. What we are afraid of is a situation where once you introduce a certificate, then all of the social partners will lose the appetite to continue to persuade people, because now they will be throwing the rule book at employees. What we want to see happen is a situation where people are persuaded. There's a lot of misinformation that is out there. Some people, all they just need is assurance. And if you are patient enough, you are able to persuade and change their minds. But as soon as you introduce the issue of certificates, you are actually moving away. Most people will not necessarily have the appetite then to persuade people. They will just say either you have a certificate or you don't, and then we all move on. Problem with that is people trying to save their jobs, they will look for that certificate, and they will get that certificate. We know that with the problems we have of corruption. But those people, just because they have a certificate and they are able to buy their way into that certificate, it doesn't mean that they are safe. So they continue to pose the very same risk that you wanted to limit by vaccinating people. So the issue here is no one can guarantee that if we move ahead with the vaccination certificate, certificate. Firstly, employers will not abuse those certificates. Also, that corruption is not going to creep in, as we are already dealing with cases of corruption, especially under COVID. That this issue of corruption will creep in again, and then people will just find their way into having access to those certificates and moving on with their lives without ever really going to vaccinate.